Hit it. Much bone, brother. How you feel, man?
Grants where there's been a music program or arts program or fine language program cut. There's grants where individuals can bring those programs into the school and collaborate. So that's why I never shut up about this.
C360, that stands for Collaborative 360, and that's where we've launched a program where we are identifying the grant funders and writing the grants for our affiliates. That can even be you if you're not already a part of C360.
And you know, Kim, again, I'm always touching on where there's grants. Even when you're doing your show, because you're touching on self-esteem, leadership skills, fighting obesity or whatever, you could be taking that into schools and grants could cover it when you do that. There's a picture with you with Oprah. You did something on the O Network.
I did a game show on the Oprah Winfrey Network. I was a co-host of a show called Are You Normal America? Uh-huh. And by the way, we are not normal.
You got that entire experience. I mean, how many people can say that?
It was great. And you can feel her energy. She has a power, a beautiful, quiet power that is actually, you know, rooted in this and how much she gives. It helps people to live again, hope again, and dream again.
Yeah.
I'm going to use that. Thank you, Jean.
Get your charity full tank. Man, does this woman deliver.
Wow, okay. I always talk to people about passion. If you're in your passion every day, how much more rewarding that's going to be and easier for you to wake up even on day when it's not easy. Again, this is Sherita J, and I am happy to be. Hi, this is Sherita J coming to you live out of Los Angeles, and it is drive time. Speaking of driving, for the past 3 weeks, we have actually, when I say we, I'm talking about my very special guest that's here in the studio with me today, and it's Mr. Ray Oglesby. But before I bring him on, I just want to let you know that over the past 3 weeks, we have literally been driving across the country. And so not only am I going to share some very special pictures many of you have seen on Facebook already, but we're going to talk about really, literally, grants that are available to do not only what we've done over the past 3 weeks, but we're going to talk about different subject matter and where there's grants for that. And so also, this trip was planned. It was planned for a very special young lady, my baby sister, Shalene Janelle, now Simmons, but she was Shalene Janelle Goff. We adopted my little sister when she was only 6 months old. She's now in her 40s. And because of a very special friend and client, Shelby Titus Walker, my little sister was introduced to her family back in Kansas City, Missouri. And so this is how the trip started. It was originally to introduce, after Shelby found her family, to introduce my sister to her family. And it just kind of turned into this bucket list trip that I've always wanted to take. And so that happened with this very special gentleman that I have here in the studio. So, but before we go there, for those of you that have sent emails and called to my office and you want to know more about grants and the nonprofit arena and for-profit nonprofit collaboration and just all that good stuff, as always, go to my website at kifoundation.org. That's kifoundation.org. And that's where you can sign up for the free grant information that we distribute on a regular basis. And then also, every first Friday, we have First Friday with Sherita J, have coffee with me. If you want to know more about that or to sign up for the next First Friday, which is coming up in April, on my website at kifoundation.org, you will see a tab that says Q&A with Sherita J. Get signed up there. And so I want to make sure, before I get started, my engineer, are we ready on my Facebook page? Okay, what I want to do is I want to introduce my very special guest, Mr. Ray Oglesby, who is sitting here. And Ray says he's never been on the air before, but he and I, for the past 3 weeks, have been traveling across the country in your beautiful, beautiful RV. How are you, sir?
I'm wonderful. And you?
I am good. I'm good. Ray, It's crazy how we ended up taking this trip. My sister, like I said, Shalene, was being introduced to her family, and you knew that I wanted to go, and you said, well, why don't we drive? And I was like, what? You know? Ray, what were we driving?
We were driving a Damien Intruder.
Yeah, yeah.
36 foot.
Yeah. When my engineer gets ready, we're going to be showing you guys a lot of the pictures from the trip. Let's see. I'm just going to, as we go into the show, I'm going to be explaining the pictures. I'm going to be talking about what we were doing. It's further down, it looks like. So before we left, we were driving through Los Angeles. I live downtown LA, and we were driving to get ready for the trip. And the 6th Street Bridge, they're rebuilding the 6th Street Bridge. Oh, well, you know what? I'll just start where we are so that we don't have to keep scrolling around. We were in Kansas City already on this particular picture. And this is a high school friend of, Sheila, her name is Sheila Griffin. And she and I, we go all the way back to third grade. And so I went and saw my dear friend Sheila because she's been dealing with cancer and breast cancer. And Sheila, we're talking about, she wasn't aware that she could be speaking to women that are dealing with cancer, all kinds of cancer, not only breast cancer. And there's a grant for that. There's funding for her to be blogging and interacting with individuals that have gone through the kind of surgery that she's gone through. And here you see, that's that's the home that I grew up in on 41st Terrace. And so, again, many of you that were following me on Facebook, you saw that I was posting my old home. And let's see, let's scroll up a little bit. What's next? Of course, that's my grade school. And now, the reason that I'm saying there's grants for that, Ray, you kept hearing me say that throughout the entire trip. As we were going across the country, we were making all kinds of stops, whether it was at the Tuskegee Airmen Trail. Yes. What were the other places that we stopped?
Didn't we stop?
Yeah. Let's see. While you're thinking about that, help me think. The reason why I say there's grants for that, you guys, is going across the country, when we're talking about the different places where we are, whether we're talking about a particular city or whatever, we also are talking about geography. And so I have it here on my notes. Let me scroll down a little bit. The National Geographic, they give funding for talking about geography. And so I didn't send this to my engineer because, of course, I was traveling crazy and just didn't do what I should have done. But the National Geographic has supported exploration and discovery, bringing gems like from the undersea wonders to new species to just new places. And what they're talking about, they say our programs, their field-based research, conservation, exploration, and education continue to provide the world with scientific breakthroughs and discoveries. Well, for instance, one of my special guests that's going to come on later, Megan Kennedy, she sent in some photos and talking about her trip that she had taken across the country. And Megan also works with individuals with epilepsy, but she also probably wasn't aware that as she was driving across the country, individuals that normally won't take these kinds of trips because of their epilepsy or whatever, she could be taking them on those trips and they could be following her, and there's funding for her because it's empowerment, it's helping to combat loneliness, depression, but also she could be talking about the health and wellness. You with me, Ray?
I'm with you.
So, but also, If there's anyone that would like to call in to talk about maybe any trips that you've taken, any questions that the different stuff that I'm talking about, you guys, I'm so tired. You can call here at 323-965-1600. That's 323-965-1600. Before I go any further, Ray, let's see. What do we have on the screen now? Oh, okay. I keep forgetting I can look up there. Those are just some of the homes that my girlfriend Barb from kindergarten, that's the top house. My cousin Talaba that follows us all the time on the air, that's her house on the left. And then on the right is a dear friend of mine, Alfred, who now lives in Oklahoma, who follows me on Facebook. That's his house. And we all grew up in the same community. So, Taliba, Alfred, if you're listening, if you've tuned in today, give us a call at 323-965-1600, 323-965-1600. I just noticed my engineer got a new haircut sitting over there looking sharp. It kind of blew me away. I'm used to seeing your old style. Let's scroll down a little bit. Up. Let's see. Up from Sheila. Let's see, where else are we going? Stop right there. That's my little sister, Shalene Simmons. And you guys, again, this is why the trip started. I will show you a picture that I posted. I call her Janelle. Her name is Shalene Janelle. And again, we adopted her when she was 6 months old. We knew nothing about her family, where they were. But come to find out, you guys, that in our home church, Mount Pleasant Missionary Baptist Church there in Kansas City, Missouri, my little sister, while she was attending Sunday school, she had no idea that in that same class that her brother and sister, her mom married after giving her up for adoption. At the time, it just wasn't right for her. At 18, she was very young. So she gave my little sister up for adoption. And we are going to have a show where I'm featuring my little sister and having Shelby Titus Walker on the air also and talking about reuniting families. But we didn't realize that her younger brother and sister were in the same Sunday school class and didn't know it until now that we have found out her family and where they went to church and all of that. So Janelle, I know you're probably not tuned in right now, which is why we didn't have you on the air. You're at Bible study and we're going to schedule a show for you. So let's move on up a little bit. Now, here, this is my Aunt Net. She's there in Kansas City, Missouri. She has Net's House of Splendor. And I wanted to stop here for a moment because there are so many beauticians and barbers that want to do more for as far as cutting the hair of low-income individuals. Or Aunt Net, you could be styling the hair for young women that are going to prom. And grants would cover that cost. And so, again, if you're not on my email list, make sure that you go to my website at kifoundation.org. That's kifoundation.org. O-R-G. If you know anyone that are beauticians and barbers, please send them to my website at kifoundation.org. Have them to sign up for the free grant information there. Let's scroll on. That's Pete cutting the hair of Ray. And Ray, let's talk about your experience with my brother Pete there in Kansas City.
That was a wonderful experience. I have never let another man cut my hair.
Uh-huh.
And Pete was just so smooth and thorough, and after he finished cutting them with those hot towels, I could have laid there and went to sleep.
yeah, well, you know, Pete's been cutting hair a long time, and he wasn't aware that there's funding for him as far as being a barber. Now, one of the things that we're doing with our family foundation is I want to create, like for instance, Senior Saturdays. There's a lot of seniors, and their only outing is to go to church. And he could have the barbershop full on Saturdays where he's just cutting seniors' hair, getting them ready to look sharp on Sunday, and grants would cover each one of their haircuts. And so, you know, but a lot of people just aren't aware of that. Let's see what's next as far as the pictures. Ah, the world champion Kansas City Royals. We just had to make that stop. Ray, what's going on there with the jacket?
Well, my jacket matches the Kansas City sign, and I just could not pass that opportunity. Not that I'm a Kansas City fan.
Well, you are now.
Well, you know, they are right.
Well, but coming, we're here with the lady
they
from Kansas City.
They got one championship. know.
Well, yeah. But you know what? Well deserved. But while we were there, we just could not resist going there and seeing that historic sign because next year it may or may not be there.
May not.
But it's been, I don't follow it that well since I've been here in Los Angeles over 20 years, but that's still my hometown. And so it felt real good to go and be able to get a picture with that historic sign.
Too.
Yeah. You know, let's see, let's scroll and see what's next. Ah, that's my cousin. But here we are at the Chiefs Stadium, which they both are on the same lot. And the Kansas City Chiefs, now we've gotten close a few times, but we haven't done anything as far as Super Bowl since Super Bowl 13.
You've done closer than us.
Yeah, Yeah. Now, where's us for you?
California.
No, I mean, but where are you from?
Oh, Pine Bluff, Arkansas.
Pine Bluff. Well, Arkansas, they don't have a team.
No,
nah,
they're only college.
No, okay. Okay. Well, but just speaking of us here in Los Angeles, we're finally getting ready to get what? Two
finally.
Teams?
One's enough.
One's enough?
We'll take
them. Yeah. Who's coming here?
Rams.
The Rams. Okay. Yes. Okay. Well, anyway, that picture was very, very fun to go and take. And the Yellow Brick Road. We were actually here at the Legends. It's a mall there in Kansas City, Kansas. A lot of people get them mixed up. There's Kansas City, Missouri, and Kansas City, Kansas. You kind of experienced that, didn't you?
Oh man.
Kansas Cityans do not like to be called Kansans. And so there's two cities, Kansas City, Missouri, and Kansas City, Kansas, and they're butted right up against each other. And if you are from Kansas City, when you say Kansas City, that means Missouri. When you are from Kansas, even though you might be from Kansas City, Kansas, you just say Kansas. And so while Ray was there with me and my family, I kept having to make sure that he was clear on that because people get offended. And I didn't realize, I've been gone a long time, and I didn't realize that it was still so deep that,
yes.
Yeah, but you did. And so anyway, that was the Yellow Brick Road because over at Legends is in Kansas City, Kansas, and the Legends has that Yellow Brick Road there, and I couldn't resist taking that picture there. Gates Barbecue. Now, I couldn't wait to have Ray taste this Gates Barbecue, but let me segue a little bit off. Ray is an amazing barbecue man. He has, what's your business?
Ray's Grill.
Ray's Grill. Tell me a little bit about it and how long have you been doing this?
I've been cooking for about 20 years. We cater.
Cater to who are some
anybody.
People?
We do anywhere from 50 to 550 people, all type of events, weddings.
Yeah. Well, I grew up on that Gates and Sons barbecue. Don't go to that one yet. Let's go back up to Gates for a moment. I grew up on Gates and Sons barbecue, and it is delicious.
Yes, it is good.
And it still was delicious when I went home. But when I had, since I've had Ray's barbecue, you guys, his texture is just so unreal. And of course, it's fall off the bone. And I'm not just saying that because he's special. I'm saying that because it is delicious. And so, Ray, if someone wants to try your barbecue, if they would like your catering, where should they reach you?
They can call, make an appointment. We can do a tasting, 951-250-2150.
Say that again?
951-250-2150.
Good. And also, they can reach you. Do you want them to reach you on social media?
Yeah, you can find Ray's Grill on Facebook. And you can also RaysGrill@yahoo.com.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, good. Now, let's scroll up back to those drinks. Ray, I'm going to let you talk a little bit about these drinks. What's up with the cocktails?
Well, after a long drive, about, it can go anywhere from 3 hours to 10 hours.
Uh-huh.
At the end of the day, the sun goes down. Nobody should drive at night. So what do? You find your spot and you have your cocktail.
Yeah.
And we were quite diligent at that.
Well, you know what? And this is another thing that I suggest to everyone. Start driving more across the country. I mean, we fly a lot, and this was such an unbelievable trip. And a lot of people would drive through the night. But you don't realize what you're missing when you drive through the night. So when it came sunset,
yes,
we were looking for a place to pull over.
Yes.
And so we pulled over and we would have our cocktails and have some of the most amazing sunsets.
Yes.
Laugh, talk,
yes.
Talk about the day, the things that we saw, and just all that good stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. So what was that drink?
That was a martina. Martini.
Martini.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it was good. I know that. Let's go to the next one. Now, here, whoa, what was that? Oh, we were just sharing with everyone all of the different sites and how quickly it would change. And so let's see, let's go to the next one. Now, this is my Uncle Jim there in Kansas City. And my Uncle Jim, he's funny, he's always a prankster, all of that. But he doesn't take to a whole lot of folks as far as somebody that he would want to be, you know, just hanging out with. But he would come over and get you, Ray, and you guys were getting ready to go fishing.
Yes, ma'am.
Share a little bit about that.
Uncle Jim came over about 9 o'clock that morning, got the poles out, got ready, and we went to like 3 different lakes.
Uh-huh.
Due to the fact that we didn't catch no fish, we had to find us a restaurant to serve fish.
Yeah.
And had a great time.
Yeah.
Man has great character, fun to be around.
Yeah. He definitely is, and he was enjoying you.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, Ray, you guys went to Lake Jacomo, I know, and I grew up fishing at that lake. Now, I know you guys didn't catch anything that day, but my very first experience fishing, I went to Lake Jacomo, and I was probably about 7.
Okay.
And I went there with my dad, and they had just stocked the lake, and it changed my life. And I was fishing with a pole, you know, the pole, and man, that bobber, watching that bobber. And they had just stocked the lake, like I said, and it was me and my brother, my dad, my Uncle Dub, who just recently passed. But like I said, it changed my life, and I think that day I caught about 60 fish, and I didn't even think that was possible. But the reason why I'm telling this story is because if you're a fisherman, there is so much funding to take young people fishing.
Yes.
And almost any hobby that you may have, if you start exposing individuals that normally wouldn't have that opportunity, then there's funding for that. And so people always tease me because they say, Sherita, everything you say, there's a grant for that. Yeah. And it is. if you're doing something to change someone's life, let's say that you're in the gym, decided to go back again, and now you go and pick up Uncle Jim being a deacon at the church.
Right.
There are some of the people that are sick and shut in. And so let's say that he went and got a few of those that are able to do some walking, and you guys take them fishing. Now there's funding for that, because there's funding to start getting seniors out or individuals that normally would not get out. And so there's a grant for that.
That's good.
Okay. Who do we have here? Oh, this is my brother Pete and Julian, and we're actually sitting in the RV. We hung out pretty much instead of hanging out in the house. We all hung out in the RV. And so, like I said, my brother Pete is a barber, and Julian, that's on the right side, that's my nephew. He's an amazing drummer.
Amazing.
Yeah, we went to a play. We'll see some pictures there that Julian was playing in the Cole, what was his name?
Cole Porter
play. And so, again, it was great hanging out with family. But my nephew, Julian, he also is like an amazing drummer and going to be working with young people as far as teaching music. But also, instead of just teaching music, there's an etiquette to being, he's played for the church as far as drums since he was probably 12. Mm. And there's an etiquette to being not only a drummer, but a drummer if you're going to be a drummer at a church. So he's going to be talking about the appropriate dress for young people and just the interaction between you and the people at the church and the pastor. And so, again, that's my brother Pete on the left and my nephew Julian. Let's go to the next one. Let's see. Oh, I was just working there in the RV on that one. We can see I'm still getting work done while vacationing. So let's move on. We were on the historic 18th and Vine there in Kansas City, Missouri. And we went and saw what was her name? Ida Macbeth. And so right there in the background, the picture on the left where we are so gazing into each other's eyes is the Blue Room. And the Blue Room is where they highlight not only professionals that are in the industry, but this is where they also give opportunities to budding artists. My nephew Julian, that I showed you on the previous, I took him to 18th and Vine. That was the first time he played to a live audience, and a lot of people don't realize it, but the Blue Room is a nonprofit. Even though it is a nightclub, and even though they do serve liquor there, because of the opportunities that they provide to the individuals and giving them the exposure. See, anytime you are giving individuals an opportunity that they otherwise could not have, then there's opportunities for you to be a 501c3. And so, again, that's where we were at the historic 18th and Vine at the Blue Room. Let's scroll on. Stop there for a moment. There at the top, you can see the amazing Ida Macbeth. And then the bottom right picture is me and my girlfriend from third grade, Angie Waters Johnson. And so she came out and we had a wonderful time there. But again, even with the band, I like to highlight just all kinds of ideas because there are so many of you. And please, you guys, please, please, please go to the website and sign up for the free grant info instead of sending me emails after the show, because I cannot address all of them. But when I'm talking here, let's say that you are in your city and you play an instrument and you would like to give other individuals the exposure. There's funding for you to include them with you as you play, and funding will be paying you because you're giving them opportunities. It actually becomes a program while you're actually operating in what you do in your profession. So that can be happening in your city, your town. Let's move on. These were also taken down on 18th and Vine, looking kind of sharp there.
Well, thank you, dear. So are you.
So let's scroll on. Here, Argosy. We were actually at a casino having breakfast. That's my Aunt Ned on the left, my Uncle Jim further back. And you see Ray and my niece sitting back there not wanting to look at the camera, Tammy, who everybody says looks like my twin, and her guy, and then Donna. And then down below, the picture on the bottom right, it's my cousin Michelle Kennedy, now Nicholas, and her husband Robert, and they were at breakfast with us that morning at the Argosy. Now, I want to stop here and talk about the Argosy for a moment. It's a casino. But a lot of people don't realize that if you are taking, let's say, seniors, taking them out for an excursion, whether it's breakfast there at the Argosy, or even just taking them down to gamble. Now, of course, the grants cannot be used for gambling, but the fact that you take seniors out for an excursion, it can be funded. We have a caller on? Let's see. Hi, Megan.
Hey, Sharita, how you doing?
I'm fine, hon. We're going to stop right here and talk about you for a moment. You guys, I have Megan on because Megan has taken an amazing trek across the country. You went, what, about 9,000 miles?
I went over 9,000 miles. I forget the exact amount.
Yeah. And I mentioned to you a little bit earlier because I've had you on the show before talking about epilepsy.
Correct.
And Megan, when you took that trip before, did you? I know that you. Let's see. Let me turn this down.
I lost you there. You said, you know what?
I know that when you. Who was it that you took on the trip? You gave me a character.
Showing the character by the name of Flat Stanley.
Flat Stanley. I'm going to see if we can look that up. Can we do? See, Flat Stanley is a character, it's a book?
Yeah, Flat Stanley is a book written back in the 60s, and basically he wakes up flat one day because something fell on him, but except for the fact that he's flat, he's okay.
He goes on
various adventures, including his parents actually send him in an envelope with a sandwich and everything to California.
Oh, okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my email. Let's see. You sent us an email, and he's going to be bringing that up because I want my audience to not only see you, but also see the wonderful pictures that you sent to us. And so, Laron, when you're ready, there is a picture of Megan, and she's against a car with these stickers on her, like she's been Megan, where you were standing against the car and you've got the numbers on you. It's in this email here.
Yeah, I believe the numbers are 1667 and 1668.
Yeah, there we are. They can see your beautiful face now, Megan. What were you doing on this picture?
So that day, in fact, you'll notice that the reason I have two numbers is if you look under the one that's up on my left.
Yes.
You'll know that there's a little character behind that. That's family. And we both had just participated in the National Epilepsy Walk in D.C. that day.
Ah, so you and Flat Stanley, you participated. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
In fact, he was the team captain.
Ah. So now, Megan, when you were on this trip, because you have been dealing with epilepsy ever since you were a little girl, correct? Or a young woman?
Since I was 18.
18. And when you were on this trip, not only did you have Flat Stanley with you, did you have individuals that are dealing with epilepsy following you on the trip?
Not necessarily epilepsy. I was actually a librarian at the time. In fact, Epilepsy Education Everywhere, the nonprofit that I started, wasn't even a glint in my eye at the time, believe it or not.
Okay.
So I went on the trip. I was a librarian at the time, and I shared the trip with both the people at the library I worked with. We had a big display, and they would move the car based on where Flat Stanley and I were in the world.
Uh-huh.
And then I also shared it with the librarian at Child Help so that she could share it with the children there.
Good, good. Well, the reason why I was asking that is because your next trip, you could definitely be blogging with individuals that are dealing with epilepsy, because you and I learned more about it when you were on the air with me. And depending on the severity of what their epilepsy, they probably wouldn't be able to take a trip like you did.
Right, and at one point I wouldn't have been able to do that trip because I actually went 9 years without a license. So that trip celebrated many things for me. So besides my 40th birthday, it was also celebrating my freedom with epilepsy, because once again I was out there driving on the road and getting to do something I hadn't been able to do for a large part of my adult life.
Yes.
But I did do a blog at the time, but the site that blog was down, unfortunately, got taken down a few years ago.
Uh-huh.
But like you said, yeah, definitely I want to do another road trip like that, do one for epilepsy, be speaking around the country on epilepsy,
mm-hmm.
and take Flat Stanley with me to new places.
Yes, yes. And that's what I was going to mention, because now that you are aware, and with your nonprofit, funding could cover you taking the trip and you interacting with individuals as you go, and also then each city or town that you go to, if it's done in advance, you could speak in those areas and funding would cover that. Because not only are you now educating about epilepsy with your nonprofit, but you also will be impacting individuals. They're helping with, again, loneliness, depression. You would be talking about geography and all of those different things, and it's fundable with your trip across the country.
I know. So if you have any connections for that, please let me know. I'd love to do it.
Well, my dear, we will have to talk further, because
I know.
if I just type in,
or if anyone listening would love to fund a trip like that, let us know.
Yeah. See, you could even get sponsorships for that. So if I'm just typing in, again, epilepsy grants, epilepsy programs, just doing a simple search. SEED grant program, the American Epilepsy Society, which you've probably already looked at. Have you looked at
that? I haven't looked at that one yet, but I am familiar with them. They do a lot more research-based, but that'll be interesting to look and see which one you found there.
Let's see. Let's go and see. I'm looking at also the grants and fellowship awardees, and then Epilepsy Maternal and Child Health Bureau also has funding. The available grants, Youth Today, Early Childhood Comprehensive Care Network Program grants for improving access to quality health. That one wouldn't fit you.
No, not quite.
Yeah, let's
see. At least not for that, so.
Yeah. Let me scroll a little bit further. Now, Megan, while I'm looking at that, let's see. LaRon, do you have another one of her photos available? Okay. While he's taking a moment. Megan?
Yes.
While you were on that trip, give us a little bit more insight on what went on.
For me, it was a matter of combining a lot of little trips I've been wanting to take into one big trip. I always thought of doing a road trip after I retired, and I thought, why wait?
Mm-hmm.
So I did a bunch of things. I got to see a bunch of friends and family across the country.
Mm-hmm.
I visited almost every home I lived in, and being a military brat, that was quite a few homes,
uh-huh.
as well as almost every place I worked in my life.
Okay.
One of my big adventures on the trip was to go to D.C. and participate in the National Epilepsy Walk.
Okay.
Visited old childhood haunts. I got to go to places I went to as a child that you appreciate a lot more as an adult.
Uh-huh.
Or even just places that I'd never been to before. And some places I didn't even know. I didn't know, like, when I left North Carolina, was I going to go south through Alabama or was I going to go, you know, through the Appalachian Mountains
okay,
when I was in Memphis. And it's like, where do I go today? Let's go this way. You know?
Let me stop you here. There's Flat Stanley on the screen, and he's with the little snowman. Where were you there?
That was actually the first full day of the trip. Our first stop was the Grand Canyon.
Uh-huh.
I made two reservations in advance, the Grand Canyon and Kitty Hawk, because I knew where I'd be both those days. Everything else was somewhat planned, but also impromptu. But I was walking along, and there were these two little snowmen that someone had made, and I'm just like, oh, perfect, they're just his size, and I set them up there.
So, and this was at the Grand Canyon.
That was at the Grand Canyon. Of course, you can't tell very much because it was a bit cloudy that day.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Well, again, now let's say that you planned this trip again.
Mm-hmm.
And because Flat Stanley, we have another picture up, and I'm going to let you know in just a moment. Because you took Flat Stanley with you, did you know that there are grants where you could have purchased hundreds of Flat Stanley books? And as you traveled across the country, let's say that you stopped and you spoke at a school, you could have been donating those books to the school, or depending on the age group, as far as Flat Stanley, I'm not familiar with the character, sorry. But okay. You could have spoken to that age group and left a book with each of the students.
No, see, that's something to know. So, see, you learn things all the time,
mm-hmm.
you know, and especially being a librarian, that would have been a perfect thing to do.
Yeah.
But, of course, I wouldn't have been able to have as much fun and just be as free, you know,
yes.
with my trip as I was.
Yes, yes. Well, I like to say all of these different ideas because there's different people that end up calling our office and there's different things that they want to do and they just have no idea that they could. So since we were talking about Flat Stanley, I wanted to make sure and mention that, because those books could be pretty costly if someone wanted to foot that bill themselves.
Oh, so, I know, and especially, it's not to say we couldn't have Flat Stanley books on this next trip, but also, you know, a book for kids about epilepsy.
Yes, ma'am. And
you know.
And even if you were giving out the Flat Stanley, if you had even a threefold or just information about your nonprofit incorporated with that, like as the bookmark, for instance, but it's a threefold, then that also leads them to your site for continual communication and education about epilepsy.
Or even better, our seizure first aid card.
Ah, okay. Yes, ma'am. Now, the next picture that we had up is a beautiful sunset.
Yes.
Where were you?
That's on the other end of the country. I stayed at a little B&B at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So that was sunset at Kitty Hawk, basically.
Okay. Now, and Kitty Hawk is where?
Kitty Hawk is in North Carolina. It's on the Outer Banks, and I went there because I wanted to go visit where the Wright brothers had taken their first flight, because my dad was a pilot.
Wow. So even being right there and talking about the Wright brothers, I mean, that's history. Ching, ching. What's the next picture? okay, we've got Lincoln, our president.
Yes, and I was going to say one more thing I realized at Kitty Hawk that I never realized before is that my parents were married on the anniversary of the first flight. And they said it was just sheer coincidence, but
still,
I thought that was pretty interesting to realize that when I was looking at the plaque, you know?
Yeah, that is interesting.
Yeah.
Coincidence.
So Lincoln, yes.
So now, what about Lincoln here?
So Lincoln, one of the things I did was I went to Gettysburg. And growing up as a kid, I saw many a Civil War battlefield.
Uh-huh.
And I thought I'd just be there for, an hour or so, look around. Only once I got there, first of all, I had this little, like an aura, for lack of a better phrase, when I was pulling into the area, just like this somber feeling. And I actually turned my radio off out of honor for everyone who had been there on the battlefield. I felt they deserved that silence.
Wow.
And everything. I just had that type of feeling.
Yes.
But I did not realize how big that battlefield really was. The auto tour for that is like 2 or 3 hours long.
Uh-huh.
And there's a museum and, of course, the Gettysburg Address. So I didn't get to see as much as I would wanted.
Yes.
But I do. That is one place I do want to go back and really spend like a few days there.
Right.
So that statue, I saw that and I saw how people had placed the pennies, which, of course, Lincoln is on the pennies.
Uh-huh.
Right. Front of the statue, and that was just another part of the trip that moved me.
So that, and again, that standing up there. How are they standing, though?
They're just leaning them up against the statue.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. How cool is that?
I know. I thought it was pretty cool.
Right.
Another place that I saw pennies, and I didn't have time to find the picture. I went to the memorial of the Oklahoma City bombing, and there was an area where they had a pathway
uh-huh.
of pennies that had been, kids had raised money of pennies and sent it in, and they incorporated it into a pathway leading to the kids area about in the museum.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Well, and you also have a picture of the monument, the beautiful
yeah.
monument there in D.C.,
I've been in D.C. many a time.
Uh-huh.
This is the first time I had ever been there during cherry blossom time.
I was going to say, look at those beautiful blossoms there.
And I took quite a few pictures of cherry blossoms and dogwoods and magnolias and azaleas and all the other flowers I grew up with.
Yes.
As a kid. But I just love the way that one, sort of, not really framed, but just the way it works in with the monument, the Washington Monument there.
Yes. Well, Megan, again, let's see. I think we have another one with your feet in some water.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, tell us the story on this one.
Okay, I was at, it's either Chincoteague or Assateague. A friend of mine in D.C. had told me about Chincoteague and Assateague, and they're sort of like right next to each other.
Uh-huh.
But there is actually a children's book based on the wild horses there at Chincoteague.
Ah.
And those are both national parks that are there in Virginia.
Okay.
And so because it was on my way to Kitty Hawk, I took a little side trip. And like I said, it's when you're on these trips, you from your trip recently, you
yeah.
can like, oh, this looks good. Let's stop.
Yeah. Let's check
well,
this out.
You know. So I went on over. I did actually see some of the wild horses, got to look around, and I grabbed a Subway sandwich. I ate my lunch on the beach, and that was the first time I'd seen the Atlantic in over 20 years, and I just had to get my feet wet.
Speaking of...
So my shoes were on. Yes, my shoes were on.
Yeah. Well, Megan, I want to thank you so much for sharing these pictures and sharing your trip. Another thing that I want to mention that many people aren't aware of, and these are some things that we're going to start working on also because Ray and I are going to take many, many more trips. Did you know that when you involve others that normally would not be able to have the opportunity that you had, there's even opportunities to get sponsorships for your gasoline.
Ah, perfect.
Yes, ma'am. So you and I need to talk further because
we need to plan a road trip together.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, that'll be
maybe
fun.
66, okay?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I'm going to be showing our Route 66 pics. And Megan, thank you so much for following us on this trip. I mean, I had so much fun sharing our pictures via Facebook, and it's just wonderful that you shared yours. And I look forward to talking to you soon. And keep on empowering not only yourself, but those individuals that are dealing with epilepsy. I really admire you, your work. And for those that, if you haven't seen when Megan was on the air, go to my website at kifoundation.org and click on KI Radio. And you will see, you can go down and see my past shows, and you can see when Megan was on, and you were jamming to our James Brown music in the beginning. And so, Megan, again, thank you for being on. Thank you for making a difference, and I love you dearly.
All right. Thank you. I look forward to talking to you again soon, all right?
All righty. Thanks again.
All right. Bye, Sherita.
Bye. Now, on the, back to our Facebook. I want to talk about some more of these pictures. And so when my engineer gets those up, let's see. We're ready. All right. Let's see. Let's scroll up a little. And we will see some different pictures, like when Ray and I, when we stopped at, this right here. Getting that big bear hug from Ray is my childhood buddy, Barb Engler, who is an absolutely phenomenal teacher in Topeka, Kansas. And that's her little sister, which is also my little sister on my left, right. Well, with the dark hair, that's Kelly Goins, well, Granny Goins. And they were on their way to a St. Patrick's Day parade for the Granny family. And they had breakfast with us also there at the casino. And so it was really great. And I was so glad for Barb to meet Ray, because she was wondering who this guy is. But before we go further, we've been asked time and time again, Ray, how we met. And so I figured that we would just let folks know that. We actually met via Facebook. And Ray, what do you have to say?
Yeah, we did. I believe it was around the 4th, the 5th.
Yeah, no. It was a very short time ago. It was a very short time ago, before your birthday.
Yes.
And your birthday
is... I poked her, she poked me.
I've got a whole new perspective on poking.
That's right.
And another friend, she encouraged me to be open. Angela Ruddock. Ruddock. I always mess up her name, and she's newly married now. And she and I had a conversation just a few weeks before you poked me on Facebook.
Okay.
And she said, Sherita, be open. She had met her husband through social media. And a lot of people are wondering now, where did this mystery man come from all of a sudden? But 3 months ago, we didn't even know each other.
True enough.
Yeah, and we decided to take this trek across the country. And you knew how much I really wanted to be there when my sister met her family.
Yes.
And you said, why don't we just drive?
Let's go.
And so it's unreal, because we've spent this 3 weeks in an RV that is not like a 5-bedroom house.
This is true.
And it's been wonderful.
It has.
You're not ready to dump me yet?
No, I'm ready to go again.
Yeah.
We shouldn't even be back yet.
Yeah, yeah. It really was amazing. Yeah. And so I've said, I need to write Facebook a letter. And it's just been an amazing time. Yeah, yeah. And so let's move on so that we can share more about how our trip was. This is when we were also down on 18th and Vine. And that's my niece at the very front. That's Tamara Goff, G-O-F-F. My nephew in the back with the emblem on his chest. And then that's her boyfriend in the white shirt, Duran, and their cousin Michael. And so we were hanging out on 18th and Vine. And again, a lot of what's down there on 18th and Vine, the Gem Theater, the African American Jazz Museum, the Baseball Museum, all of those are nonprofits on the historic 18th and Vine. And of course, when there's funding for that. Let's go next. Now here, Ray, we were hanging out. You were meeting my sister-in-law, Nita.
Yes.
And my nephew, Everett, and his wife, Twyla. And of course, Nita's puppy that also spoke to you. At first, though, that female, Roxy, we were staying in the RV directly across. My brother has an open field across from his house, and that's where we parked and spent a lot of our time. And of course, the RV is big enough. That's really where we all hung out. No matter where we went, no matter what city we were in, we hung out in the RV. I have a whole new respect for RVs also. And so we were having fun that day. Let's scroll on. That was us saying goodbye or see you later to, we were at the Argosy.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. You're looking kind of sharp there, Ray.
Thank you.
And that's me and my sister-in-law, Nita, and Barb, and the pups hanging out. Let's see. There's so much to tell about this trip. Saying bye to my brother, Pete. Again, the barber, there's a grant for that. If you're a barber and you want to cut the hair, Pete is... been cutting the hair of foster youth and all of that since he...
Right there.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good one. Tell us about that one.
I met this young man, her nephew. I just fell in love with his shoes.
Yeah, yeah.
So what did he do? He gave me a pair.
He gave you, and those are the pair, the ones with the higher boot.
Yes.
At the toward the bottom of the picture. And isn't it something that he had them in his car?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So Everett.
Thank you.
He's still loving those boots.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Because I was talking, I was like, aren't those called duck boots or something? And he was went on talking about them and then had a pair in the car. So there we were driving through, where were we? Going through Oklahoma or what?
I can't tell.
Let's see. Left Kansas City. Oh, we were leaving Kansas City, headed toward Topeka. Let's move on because we were going through Topeka and to see my girl Barb and her family, and that's her husband Paul at the top left in a black sweatshirt, and that's her son Kyle down at the bottom and his girlfriend, and she's really a funny girl.
Oh, that girl is hilarious.
Yeah, that just, and we were having a good time there. I guess she didn't want to take that picture though, huh?
She's cracking me up.
Yeah, and that was a fun restaurant. And then Barb and I had coffee together. It's been years since she and I have been able to sit and have coffee.
I slept.
Yep, you slept in. And then later, look at that.
Yes.
It's like Barb was saying, here, you need some help there. You were replacing the, doing something with the wiper blades.
Yes.
Yeah, so that was fun. And again, Barb is a teacher in Topeka, and there's major funding for teachers that are making a difference. She works with her. She's teaching at an inner city school, predominantly African-American and Latino. And then here I said, how many people does it take to change wiper blades? And I said 6. 4 to supervise, 1 to actually change the blade, and 1 to take the picture.
That's right.
So yeah, we had a good time there with Barb and her family. We're saying our see you laters there.
My new family.
Your new family. Yeah. Still changing the blades, and that's the RV that took us all across the country. She ran amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah, yeah. So let's move on. Where's all of our pictures with us at the, like some of the borders and all of that? That's the Flint Hills. Let's move on. Driving on. Oh, Fort Riley. Ah, right okay. Here. Eisenhower. We stopped now, here. That. What about that?
Eisenhower. I've been on trips all my life. Never once have we ever stopped anywhere other than a gas station or a McDonald's. This trip, if we saw it, we stopped.
Yeah.
And to stop at Eisenhower's, what would we call this?
Memorial. He had a monument, but there was also a library and a museum there.
And a cemetery, his resting
spot. Oh, yeah, the resting place
for
he and
family. Was more than we had expected. You know,
And that wasn't planned. We would just go see what was over there. Yeah, yeah. Now, speaking of grants, I stopped and I looked this up for today. The Eisenhower, they have Eisenhower grants, and you can go to eisenhower.archives.gov. That's eisenhower.archives.gov. And the Eisenhower Presidential Library, that they have travel grants. And it says here, assist scholars, research primary sources in such fields as history, government, economics, communications, and international affairs, so they may provide informed our nation's life. The grant program is funded and administered by the Eisenhower Foundation. So for those that want to know more, you can just do a Google search, Eisenhower Grants, and look at more. Now here, on that short video, that was you and I was just filming you driving and talking about where we were going, and we had... who was that playing? At last, Etta James.
Etta James.
We had her playing, and of course, there's my feet stuck up in the window. But we were having a really good time there. And let's scroll on. Cocktail time. Yeah, we, matter of fact, on Facebook, people were starting to say if they knew it was about sunset, we would get, interaction on Facebook or either text talking about, are y'all pulled over yet? What was that cocktail?
Those were vodka gimlets.
Yeah. Well, we might start looking at some sponsorships next. You know, there's a grant for that.
Yes.
That's my Aunt Nat, who I love, 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 and that's you.
That's me.
Now, she's your Aunt Nat.
That's right.
Now, speaking of, she sent us something here on Facebook. Let me tell you what she said recently. Don't leave there. I'll read it on my Facebook. She says here on the picture there where we returned last night, she says, thank you guys for letting us take a trip with you and your wonderful partner. How nice it was to travel along and see the many wonders that God laid out for us, and we did not buy gas. And when we stopped, we did not pay for the hotel, and we didn't get tired of driving. Ha, ha, ha. Love you guys, and you can't do nothing about it. So that's from my Aunt Nat. She's at Deer's Daycare on Facebook. And so thank you, Aunt Nat. We love you, too, and
yes.
Thank you for following us on the trip. Okay? See what's next. A few more minutes. Colorado, you were just so wonderful about stopping. I mean, I'm a picture fanatic, and that's one of the reasons why I love Facebook. And you were always so great about, even if I was missing something, you're like, babe.
That's right.
You want to stop here?
That's right.
And we stopped at every border and took pictures. That's us at Colorado. And before we have to end the show, I do want, let's scroll up and see if we see a few more, because one of the most memorable ones was Oklahoma.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can catch that one. Oh, that's Wyoming. Okay, let's go on.
This morning.
Oh, beginning. Man, we saw just a beautiful sight. This way, trying to get the snow, driving in Wyoming. And let's see, beautiful bridges. As you can see, we were just keeping everybody up on the trip. Amazing sunset again. That was driving into Evanston. That was River
yes.
Tunnel. Yeah.
She drove.
I did drive a little.
Yeah, she drove.
I drove a little. That's us having coffee with my son and my daughter-in-law. That's Jermaine Herring and Chelsea Herring. We're in Evanston, Wyoming. Jermaine and Chelsea made us some wonderful, not just coffee, but what did he call them? Whatever it was.
Yeah.
It was great. And let's scroll a little more.
Ice fishing.
Yeah, let's see if we can get to the ice fishing. That's having mamas in the kitchen. We went ice fishing. Jermaine's working on Ray's computer. We went to the hall. Of course, my son, I just had to highlight how sharp he was there. That's true. And that's my oldest son, who is an artist, and he does personalized shoes, and so I was just kind of advertising my boys there.
For
a little
was,
more. There we go. Yeah. Ice fishing. I had never experienced that. Was that your first time?
That was my first time walking.
Yeah, yeah. And we did catch fish.
We did catch fish.
And they ended up setting up a tent. If you can scroll a little more, there's pictures of us. That's Ben. Ben was nice enough to be our guide. He's a friend of my son's, Jermaine's, and they go to the same hall.
He had all the equipment that was needed.
Yes, yes. That was an amazing experience. We've done so much in this short period of time. And there, I'm like, are you sure we're going to do this? And those are still more ice fishing. We stopped at every Walmart.
Walmart in the United States.
Yeah, we're going to look for them to be a sponsor on our next trip, too. Because everything that we were needing, we found at Walmart.
You can get it at Walmart. You can find a Walmart anywhere.
Yeah, yeah, and even stuff for the RV.
That's right.
Yeah, they're very well stocked. And that's us sitting inside the tent on ice fishing. And, Ray, you had just made me some nice hot chocolate. And then we attended the Celtic Festival there in Evanston. And that was held at the old rail yards. And that's, again, my son and daughter-in-law. And we just had a great time there. Ray, as we're coming to a close, anything that you would like to say about the trip or?
Get out more and stop and look. We pass up so much beauty that is within 200 miles of us.
Yeah, that's right. And what'd you say about the 15 in Vegas?
I didn't even know there was land on the other side of Vegas. I don't know how many times I went to Vegas.
Yeah, yeah.
But go on the other side of Vegas. It is beautiful.
Yeah, yeah, it really is. We took the southern route out Interstate 40.
Yes.
And then
coming back.
And there we are at Utah, the border. And then coming back, we took the northern route. We're kind of afraid to do that because of
the weather.
the
That's it.
Oh yeah, we were. That's when we went to the Virgin Canyon.
Yes.
And Virgin Canyon is in Utah.
Utah.
Yes, it was so beautiful, and so.
And you can camp there overnight for $8.
Yeah, it's just unreal, you guys. So what we're saying is, get out and let's start seeing our country more. I'm so glad that instead of flying, that we drove
exactly.
to Kansas City. I saw so much more, and we're missing what's available, what our country is really about.
Our children aren't enjoying those cross-country rides.
Right, right. Well, I want to thank you so much because you gave me the trip of a lifetime, and I want to thank Facebook for pokes, you know? So, yes. And again, Ray, I want people to be able to taste your absolutely phenomenal barbecue. How do they reach you?
951-250-2150.
And your Facebook?
Ray's Grill.
Ray's Grill. R-A-Y-S-G-R-I-L-L.
Yes.
This is Sherita J coming to you, Drive Time from L.A., and I wanted to share this with you, our trip of a lifetime, checking off a whole lot of things that were on the bucket list, and there's a grant for that. So if you want to know more, go to my website at kifoundation.org, kifoundation.org. I want to thank you again, Mr. Ray Oglesby, for poking me on Facebook and coming and being on the air with me. You guys join me next week. Stay informed and be safe.
Hit it. How you feel, brother?
Feeling good.
You feel good?
Feeling good.
Play so much bone, brother. How you feel, man?
I feel all right.
I call your name. I don't want no people to know you're in here. How you feel, fella? Hey, yeah. Sure getting down. You want to do it again, huh?
Lunch with Sherita J. If we could get more people to collaborate with our nonprofits, we could be bringing a lot more programs back to our schools because there's grants where there's been a music program or an arts program or fine language program cut. There's grants where individuals could bring those programs into the schools and collaborate. So that's why I never shut up about this. C360. That stands for Collaborative 360, and that's where we've launched a program where we are identifying the grant funders and writing the grants for our affiliates. That can even be you if you're not already a part of C360. And you know, Kim, again, I'm always touching on where there's grants. Even when you're doing your show, because you're touching on self-esteem, leadership skills, fighting obesity or whatever, you could be taking that into schools and grants could cover it when you do that. There's a picture with you with Oprah. You did something on the O Network.
I did. I did a game show on the Oprah Winfrey Network. I was a co-host of a show called Are You Normal America?
Uh-huh.
And by the way, we are not normal.
You got that entire experience. I mean, how many people can say that?
It was great. And you can feel her energy. She has a power, a beautiful, quiet power that is actually, you know, rooted in this and how much she gives. It helps people to live again, hope again, and dream again.
Yeah.
I'm going to use that. Thank you, Gene.
Myself and Sherita here, you want to get your charity to full tank? Man, does this woman deliver. She gets your charity to full tank.
Wow. Wow. Okay. I always talk to people about operating in their passion. And if you're in your passion every day, how much more rewarding that's going to be and easier for you to wake up, even on days when it's not easy. Again, this is Sherita J, and I am happy to be bringing you our show.